Hi guys, so I'm back with another video today. I was kind of going back and forth between wanting to do a tutorial or doing a like favorites kind of video. So I thought I would do a Morphe favorites video. I have a lot of products by Morphe and I wanted to kind of share what products that I think are the best and that I think you should take the plunge and buy. I think that they have a lot of good products and they're such a good brand and they sell quality products for a good price. Let's go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna start with the eyeshadow palettes first. I have eyeshadow palettes, some face palettes, brushes, and then some individual eyeshadows. So the first palette that I'm gonna talk about is probably no surprise. Let's be serious, this is probably Morphe's like most popular famous palette they have. But it is the Morphe 35O. This is by far their best eyeshadow palette that they have. It's my favorite by far. They just have, like, the pigmentation is so good. It's so creamy, so blendable. Perfect for fall. I know it's out of stock, but if you can get your hands on it and somehow get it, then get it because it is so worth it. I happen to get it like when it first came out and I was so happy because let's be serious, this has my name written all over it. I'm all about like the oranges and the warm tones and this just screams Katrina. So I haven't used any other palette honestly besides this one. I'll at least use like one color in here every single day because it's just that good. This color right here is so pigmented, like it gets me every time. The next palette that I'm going to talk about is the other palette that I really like. It is the 35T palette. This one has more taupey shades. It also has some warms and some golds in it. I like this palette a lot. It also has really good pigmentation as well. The next palette that I think is good, especially if you're a makeup artist and you need some eyeshadows in your kit, this is the 35K palette. It has warms, cools, neutrals, whites, champagnes, browns, grays, blacks. It has everything and this is just really good to just throw in your kit and to have it in there because even if you have like other eyeshadow palettes that you want to bring, you could at least always have this one and know that it has everything that you'll probably need for like a neutral, smoky, natural kind of look. So that's why I really like this palette. This is, I think, Morphe's newest palette. This one is the 35P, I think, but this one is like I think their newest one and that's why I picked it up because I wanted it for my kit specifically because it just has everything and this brown right here is life. And the last palette that I think was really worth it, I don't know if they still sell it anymore either. I know they still have it at the store, I believe, so if you live in LA you could still probably pick it up. This is the Jaclyn Hill Jaclyn Hill Favorites palette. There we go. These are just their individual eyeshadows that she put into a palette and it sold like that. So if you like any of these colors in the palette, they do sell them individually for $2. This palette caused like complete chaos when it first came out. I didn't get it the first time around. I did get it the second time it went back into stock. But like these ones are really, really, really good. Like I said, these are their individual eyeshadows, which are very good quality. They're very pigmented. I'm wearing the green shade right here on my eyes right now. I always kind of tend to go back to this too. Now going into face kind of palettes, this is the Morphe 9B. This is their blush palette. This has a bunch of different blushes. I have this in my kit because it has a blush for every skin tone. It has nudes, pinks, corals, bright colors for darker skin tone, mauves, like rosy colors. These are super, super, super pigmented. You really just need to dab your brush in it barely and then tap it off because these are really pigmented. But they also last a long time on the face. I really like this like coral color up here. The next palette I have, a lot of Morphe palettes I have because I like to put them in my kit because it's easy to just have a bunch of palettes instead of having individual products. So this one is really good, not only for yourself, if you need this many colors or if you change your hair color a lot, but I have this for my kit. This is the Brow 7 palette. It has 6 brow colors and the wax. I use this on every single client that I have. I use this on them. And the last palette I'm going to talk about is good if you're also a makeup artist, because this is their 15 concealer palette, so 15 con palette, that's what it's called. These concealers are a little dry. I like to warm them up with my finger first. Some of them are a little bit more dry than others, but this is a good palette to have if you need a bunch of concealers for your kit if you're just starting out. I did have this in my kit. I don't use it as much anymore, but it is a good palette if you need like different concealers, because I know when I was first starting out, I didn't have a bunch of concealers, and it's just really good because it has something for every single skin tone, and that's what's good about it. And they're also very full coverage as well, and that's why I think that at least if you're looking for some concealers in a palette, this is a good one. The next things I'm going to talk about are their individual eyeshadows. I have a couple. My favorite is Secretive, ES71. So Secretive or ES71, that's both of the names. This is really similar to Makeup Geek's Bitten. It's almost identical. I have both of them. I love shades like this. That's why I have a bunch of shades like that. But this is super similar to Makeup Geek's Bitten. Really pigmented. That came off really bad. But yeah, super pigmented. I use that color a lot. And the other color I really like is the shade Bridesmaid, or ES16. It's this shade right here. It's just like a nice mauve-y color. Swatch it. I use this shade a lot, especially for like mauve-y looks that I need, or like purples, or even like I'll mix these two shades together too to create like a softer burgundy kind of look. And the other shade that I really like is, what is this one called? Pink Moscato. It's like a nice pinky, like champagne color. These are also really pigmented too. I don't know if that one's going to show up because it is kind of light, but yeah, that one's a good one too. But these ones are only $2. And the last things I'm going to talk about are their brushes. These are just a few of my favorite. I have a ton. But I'm going to talk about the three that I think that you guys should pick up. I can basically do every single eyeshadow look possible. If I could only have three brushes, it would be these three. This is the MB23, M433, and the M441. These brushes are amazing. I have three of the MB23s because this is the best like fluffy blending brush I've ever used. It's super soft. Blends everything out like a dream. I don't know what I ever did without this brush before. So yeah, this is, you need this. It's like holy grail status. And then the M433 is really similar to the MAC 217. I like this more than my MAC 217 just because my MAC one kind of sheds and I don't like that. But yeah, and these are all kind of dirty because I do use these brushes like every day. So yeah, this one you definitely need. And these brushes are all super cheap. None of these brushes are really expensive. And this is the M441. This is more of like a tapered blending brush. I love this brush too. I use this one all the time, just to kind of get some like precision blending kind of. The next brush is kind of similar. This is the E28. This is part of the Elite collection. Same kind of deal, tapered blending brush. The bristles on this are super soft. All the Elite brushes are. If you could still get your hands on some of the Elite ones, I would, because they're really, really, really good. The next brush that I'm going to talk about is the G20. This is part of the Gunmetal collection. This is just like a regular flat shader brush, synthetic, really good for packing on colors to the lid. Especially, I like to use this brush especially for the foiled shadows for Makeup Geek, because if I need like, because most of the times I'll go in with the foil shadows with my fingers. But if I really need to get like right in somewhere or like right up to the crease, I like this brush because it's really small. The next brush that I can't live without, this is the M438. This is the tapered, I don't know what it's called, but I use it for underneath the eye. Really soft, gets right into like those inner corners, and that's why I really like it. There's a MAC brush that looks exactly like this. I don't know the name of it, but it's almost identical. This brush is the E8. This is really good for buffing out concealer. I use this on all my clients for buffing out concealer, especially like cream concealer. It buffs it out really nicely, super soft. Also part of the Elite collection, so if you could still get your hands on it, I would. This is the M501, probably best brush by Morphe, or one of the best brushes. This is the one that I use for highlighting, like the tops of my cheekbones, all over my face pretty much. This is the one that Jaclyn Hill always talked about for using it for highlighter. This is the Morphe G17. This is technically a blending brush. For me at least, I think it's too big to blend out eyeshadow. I use this for blending out concealer as well as the E8. I used this actually one day when I forgot my concealer brush at my house when I went to a client's house to do her makeup. And I just used this and it ended up blending it out really well. So I use this for concealer all of the time now. And the last one is the Morphe M405. I use this to contour. If you guys want to see how I contour, I do have a video on that, so you can see me use this brush. I used to use the Morphe G30, which is like a chiseled kind of chiseled brush. It gives you a really harsh line if you're using it with powder. It is good for cream contouring, but for powder contouring, I like this one a lot more because I can get right into the hollow of the cheekbone but blend out with this part over here. So that brush is really good. So those are my favorite things from Morphe. I do have some more brushes, but I thought I would talk about my favorite ones at least. Like I said, Morphe is a really good brand, super good quality, and really affordable. And that's why I really like it, because especially as a makeup artist, I like to buy a lot of things, especially palettes. And they, like, the palettes are amazing for the price too. A lot of them are, I think they're, most of them are like $20 to $25 range. Plus, if you use like a code, all of like the YouTubers have codes with them. And also, if you're a makeup artist, you can also sign up for their pro discount, which is what I have. I'm so happy I do, because I buy a bunch of stuff from them. So yeah, I hope that this video was helpful for you guys. If you guys have any questions about any of the products or anything, leave me comments down below or ask me on my Instagram. I'll leave my Instagram down below. And also let me know down below what videos you guys want to see. I'm kind of in like a rut right now where I don't know what to film. I've kind of just been really busy and like uninspired to do things. So leave me comments down below to let me know what you guys want to see. So yeah. Alright guys, I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye. Alright guys, I will talk to you guys in my... What did I just say?